ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमो। महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरतिशे नमः। गुरवे गौरचन्द्राय राधिकायै तदालयै कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो। यं प्रप्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्यं द्वैपायनो विरहकातरयाय पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोभिनेतु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं हनुमान् कृष्ण। तवैवास्मि तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति विज्ञाय राधे तं नयमाम चरणं। What you have to do, do first, not in middle. Anything you should prepare first. Don't disturb. पहले से क्यों नहीं ठीक होता?
किसी ने छेड़ा है पीछे से सुबह के बाद
में। Material machines sometimes cheat. It was okay just a few minutes before.
हमको डिस्टर्ब होने में बड़ा खराब लगता है, हमारा भाव में सब नष्ट हो जाता है। इसको थोड़ा सा इधर नहीं किया जा सकता किसी तरह से?
अभी कर देता हूँ,
बीच में लेकर के दे। यहाँ पर क्यों नहीं लगा देता?
जैसे इतना तेज नहीं पकड़ेगा नहीं।
San Francisco. First of all, Shastang Dandak Ganati and the Lotus Feet of our Srila Gurudev. And after that, Shiksha Guru Om Vishnupad, Nitya Lila Pravishta Om Vishnupad, Shri Shri Guru Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj. We have completed Dehuti Kapil Sambhat, Nard Upakhyan, Puranjan Upakhyan, Bharat Maharaju, Ajamil, Pritasur, all there. I wanted to tell about something about Prahlad Maharaj. But I also want to tell, speak on 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. But it is basic, like a platform. So, what is the essence of Prahlad Maharaj? And what is the essence of the
teachings of
Ambarish Maharaj. Very quickly we will do, and then we will proceed towards Srimad Bhagavatam 10th canto. Prahlad Maharaj, in that Yudhishthira Maharaj asked some questions to Narada Rishi that Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, He has no enemy, He has no friend. He is equal to all. But we see sometimes that He takes part of devotees and He fights and kills all the demons. Why He does so? Why? Then He told that a mother never becomes any party of his four sons. He loves equal, but according to their health or their activities, sometimes she chastises one, not giving so delicious food to them, sometimes loving so much. But he has the same love and affection for his child. So, Krishna is like that. Like sun, if anyone come in front of sun, not covered, then he will test his rays and there will be light. But anyone sitting in the room, nothing to see sun, then there will be darkness. So this is not a
fault of sun.
No, no. Unka ex party,
mane partiality.
Partiality. There is no partiality. Partiality. If he will come out of room, he can
see
sun and his hotness and everything. Anyone coming to Krishna with six ways. Kaam means lust, bhaya,
fear,
also dvesh,
envious,
sneha, and
greed.
No.
Crowd. Anger.
Oh, yeah. He's telling
Kamad Desat
Bhayat. Kamad Desat Bhayat.
Snehat.
Snehat. I come thinking that I am himself, him, and Bhaktya. Bhakti. There are six things. तस्मात् वैरानुबंधेन निर्वैरेण भयेन वा स्नेहात् कामेन वा जुञ्जात् कच्छन् निरीक्षते पृथक् कामात देशात भयात स्नेहात जथा भक्तरेश्वरे मन आवेश तदंग हित्वा बवस्तत गति गोप्य कामात कंस आद भयो कंसो चैद्याद यो निपा संबंधात विष्णु स्नेहं जूजं भक्ता एनीवन व्हिच कम्स टू कृष्ण एंड ही इज ऑब्जर्व्ड इन कृष्ण कामात कामात मीन्स
My lust.
Lust. Dveshat.
Envious mood.
Envious mood. Bhayat.
Fear.
Fear. Snehat.
Affection.
Affection. Affection. And Bhaktya. Bhakti. Avishya. Avishya means being totally observed. Bhavas tadang gatim gatam. So many persons, devotees and non-devotees, they have got liberation and so many gatis. He is telling gopya kamat by lust gopis. I think there is no proper word, lust. Only calm is okay. Like gopis, mood of gopis. Bhayat kanso, always comes fearing from Krishna, from birth of Krishna. Before that, when he heard the sky, then MC began. Oh, thinking always Krishna, 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 he will kill me, he will kill me. Today he will kill me. I should kill him, I should kill him. Where he is? Where is Krishna? Where is Krishna? Totally observe. So concept. Deshat chaidyado. Chaidya. Chaidya means Shishupal. And others like his brother. Dantabhakra. And so many. So they were fighting with Krishna. They wanted to kill Krishna. But always observe in Krishna. Sambandhat Vishnya. Vishnya means Vasudeva, Devaki and all others. Akrur, Uddhav and all. By Sambandhat, by relation, that Krishna is my father, Krishna is my husband, Krishna is my son, Krishna is my friend, Krishna is my son, daughter in son-in-law. Like this. All Sambandha. And Snehadyujam. Snehadyujam, Sneha. Affection for Pandavas, you, Nadi telling. He has a very good relation with you. He has become your brother-in-law, Arjun. Krishna has given his
sister.
He is the son of Arjun is, and Pandava is son of Kunti. And where Kansa is, son of Vasudev.
Krishna.
And Vasudev and
Kunti
were
brother and sister.
Brother and sister. So these are Sambandha. And Vayam, Vayam means Narada is telling you. Vayam, not only one. So many bhakts. By bhakti we have. But by bhaya dvesh. It's very powerful. Very quickly. Kansa and Shishupal and others, they gave their mind towards Krishna very easily, that Krishna will kill me. So by this liberation, very quickly. But to serve Krishna like gopis, Vishnaya and bhaktas like
Narada,
oh, it is not so easy. But we should not do all the three, like dvesh, bhaya and all other things. They are not bhakti. So Krishna used to kill demons and to give this, distribute all these things. So anyhow, if anyone having salvation and all liberation and all these things by thinking enemy even, by fear, they got so much high things that yogi could not have these things. So if anyone having so much love like gopis to Krishna, thinking that he is worldly person, I am worldly, no harm. He will have more and more things from Krishna. So Krishna, outwardly it is seen that Krishna is cutting the head of Shishupal, killing his father-in-law, mama, Kansa, and killing so many. But he is not killing. He is taking only garments that was wrong and very dirty and rotten, and gives them very beautiful body and engages in his service. But we are outwardly we cannot feel, but inwardly that is worse. So Krishna is never partial to anyone. He is equal to all. But devotees are nearer serving him, so he is repaying them. If anyone will be vimukh to Krishna,
opposite.
opposite that Krishna will kill, and then by transcendental body he will engage in him anyhow. Then second thing is that
Krishna ke marne se Sajid ji mukti to nahi
mil jayega. Jo kuch chahega, jo kuch chahega wahi mil jayega.
Anyone who is in this dvesh and all,
it seemed that Shishupal has taken Sahiji Mukti in Krishna, him
emergence,
but not like that. What we think, the modes of Sahiji and all other things, it will not come in our this mind.
It's beyond our conception.
So then Hiranyakashipu, his brother was killed by Varahadev, no? And his body was brought to palace, and all were weeping. He used to know all the principles of Vedas. He also knew that Atma is Amar,
immortal.
Immortal. But he was not
following
all these things. But he knew.
We have knowledge but not realization.
There must be one supreme personality of Godhead. He knew. And he knew that Vishnu is that person, and he used to quarrel. So he wanted to kill Vishnu. So when his brother was dead and killed by Varahadev, then all were weeping. His mother, wives, children, so many children, very big, big demons they were. All were weeping for their father. Then he told a past history that there was a king whose name was
Sujagga.
And he was an emperor, and he has some
competitor.
A rival.
Enemy.
And he wanted to smash him. But in the battle, he was
defeated
and
killed.
His hands
separated from
the body. These feet also separated. But anyhow, the whole body was taken to palace, and all were weeping. They covered that body with a white cloth, and thus all were weeping. There was none to pacify them. In the meantime, a boy came of age of 5 years. He was about quite naked. He told that, "Why you are weeping? Oh, you are boy, you should go and play." But he told that, "I want to know why you are all weeping." They told that the father of this person, or this person, has killed and he has been killed. That is why we are weeping. In India, we can tell that "Wah mar gaya," meaning he has
left.
Anywhere he has gone. He told that, "I am saying that he has never gone anywhere. He is still sleeping here. Why you are not talking with him? You thought that he is my father, he is my husband, he is my son. So why you are not talking?" They told that, "No, now he is not in this body. He has left." "Oh, I used to think that this body was your father, your husband, your son and everything. But you are not weeping for this body. You are weeping for anything else." They told, "Yes, his soul has gone away. Have you ever seen? Never, we have not seen. Then why weeping? Lakhs and lakhs person daily, they used to die. But why you are weeping for this person? How he was old? How in length
tall.
He was?
Tall.
Long or tall? How he was fat or very
lean and thin?
Lean and thinner. Can you tell? No, we have never seen him. So then, even you have not seen him and you are all weeping. Why weeping? You must know that this body is not so. He will not return. He will never return. If what we speak of you, you are 100,000. But if whole world come assembled and all will be, will he come? He will never come. Jadgatva?
No nivartanti.
No, arita. From there anyone never comes where he has gone. Don't be. After that he told that, I'm telling one story, that there were two birds, wife and husband. One day they went to forest for to pick up something for their children. And they were sitting on the
branch
of a very beautiful tree. And from there, they saw some rice grain there, very beautiful, like pearls. The wife told, I want to go and to pick up. Husband told, don't go. There is some conspiracy. There is some hunter. And he will anyhow trickly catch you. So don't go. Sister told, oh, you male persons always see like this. I will go. And telling so, she quickly went there and began to pick up. And by his like, oh, come on, come on, you should also. And in time, the hunter was there. He was very black and tall and very ferocious body. He pulled the chain of the
trap.
And she at once came in his trap. And then he began to weep bitterly. Then. Also his husband came and began to weep. I cannot support my children. I wanted to be in this trap and you come out of this. But it cannot be done. And he was also bitterly weeping. And in the meantime, the hunter took his bow and arrow and hunted, and it came in the heart, and at once he fell flat on the earth. Blood was coming. And then he became happy and doing like that and laughing, and he came and he picked up both. And then he tightened and he took here and he went to home, and in the fire he did anything? Frosted. And then easily with two hands. Very beautiful, very tasteful. So all are with the same. One day you are thinking that I will not die. I am so happy by drugs, wines and three W's.
Wine,
so,
women, and
wealth.
I am so happy. I will be up to that time like this, eating, drinking and making merry. But one day you will have to be too old and you will have to test your all bad activities. Everything. So, you are telling that we should be ready. If my wife, my husband or anything has been dead, then we should be ready. Not so much weeping. Always telling, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama.
body is not soul, we are not related to this body, we are related to somehow in soul, that all are part and parcels of God and all are eternal servant of Krishna, so we have something. Don't miss these things. Always think like this. If any devotee has been weak, and anyhow he is weak to give up his
bad habits.
No. Gurudev. Oh. Anyhow, he should again come. We are requesting very eagerly or
humbly
that they should again return and serve their Gurudev and thus be happy forever. So this is one thing, one teaching of Prahlad Maharaj. Second, his father told, what you have learned in school? He told that this world is like a whale.
Blind.
And anyone was going to forest, far, far, to have some honey to taste, and killing so many animals, like deers, very innocent deers, or anything. Khargosh means?
Rabbits
and all others. But in the way, he saw a tiger running after him, roaring so well. There are so big trees, so fat. He could not climb, and he wanted to escape anyhow. But there was no way. Now he was thinking that, I have done so many wrong things, that is why this tiger is coming. And then he feared so much, and he saw that there was a dry well. And there were so many grasses and little trees.
Branches. Small trees.
And thus it was covered with the leaves and branches of these trees. So many. The root was upside, and their branches like this. The root of this world is there, and everything is lower down. And he quickly catch hold of two branches. And he began to. And he looked and he saw that, there are so many poisonous blacks.
Serpents
or snakes. And they are hissing.
Hissing their heads.
Like that. Fush. And he began more fear. If I am going up, tiger is there. If I am going
down,
then
snake will bite me.
And at once I will die. So he was, but how much time he will catch hold? This will be
painful.
And in the meantime, two rats came out from the well, any hole. One
black
and other
white.
And they began to cut. Quickly, in a moment they will
bite you.
And there is none there to save him. What to do in the meantime, he saw. I was going in the forest to take madhu, and madhu is here. Madhu means honey.
Honey
is there. And some honey from the
dripping.
By drop. One, two, like golden and very sweet. And he saw he could not check his tongue, and he did like this, keeping the branches in hands. Rats are cutting, the snakes are hissing, and tiger is roaring. Everywhere, up, down, side, this side, everywhere death is.
Severe danger.
Death is only
ready to swallow.
And in the meantime, he took this Oh, how beautiful, how tasteful, how sweet. What is this?
The enjoyment in the material world.
To love, the love of children, wife, husband, each other. All these are like madhu, or drop. And all these are fears are there. But it is very fear that if the branches are like done like this, then all bees will come and
sting.
And at once they will also die. So madhu will be, honey will be also the reason of his life. Everywhere. So keeping this, living all these things, if anyone, anyhow, maintaining his life, anyhow, and always chanting, remembering Krishna, in the association of bona fide Guru and Vaishnava devotees, then he will be happy. Tiger will go, a very, what is these rats?
Day and night.
Day and night. What are they doing?
Eating away your life.
They are cutting the tree. What is tree?
Time.
Or past bad and good actions. Our age. They are cutting. What is your age? My age is 84. Oh, oh, you have passed your 84. Now how many years are there remaining? Only 2 or 3 or one day, we don't know. So don't be
proud.
So happy and
proud.
Oh, proud of your age that I have become of 100 years. Nothing. 100 has years having passed uselessly. Uselessly. You'll have to suffer for your each action in your dream, knowingly, not knowingly, what you have done. You'll have to take
reaction.
Meat means
meat.
M-E-A-T.
Eat.
Me eat. To whom I am now eating?
Eat me.
They must eat. Being tigers, snakes, or anything, flesh, that is, they will, maybe cows, they may be deer, hawks, pigs, hens, and they will take your flesh. So give up, try to give up all these things. Krishna has made so many things to eat. Why eating all these things? You can drink milk. Why alcohol and all other things? You should not do all these things. Try to remember. So if anyone doing like so, at once, rain may come and some pieces of
hail.
Will come and tiger will go away. The rats will
run.
Go away easily, and then he can come out of the well and he can easily be saved. So we should try to hear. He is telling to his father. Hearing this, his father becomes so angry and he threw out his from his lips and began to just kill him, but he could not do anything. Their master Sandamark advised him to return this boy to Gurukul and we will teach him. In the meantime, our father Shukracharya will come. He is very powerful, and thus this boy can be saved. He will not be devotee. He told Hiranyakashipu, any devotee should not come in or that area where my boy is there. They have done this thing. Then again he came to school and he read for some time. And again his father asked, what you have read and what you have selected good? And what your Gurudev has told. Then he told, what? Shravanam, Kritanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Pada Sivanam, Archanam, Bandanam, Darshanam, Sakham, Atmanivedanam, इति पुंसार्पिता विष्णुस्य नवलक्षणा भगवती क्रियेत मन्ने तन्मन्यधीत मुक्तमा. Sometimes being a devotee, coming out of the association, we think that Buddhism is so very easy, so easy. Then we see that, I'm Brahmasmi, I am same. Why should I serve Krishna? I am himself Krishna or Supreme Personality of God. These bad things comes in heart. Sometimes we see that, we should be Sahajiya Babaji. Our Gurudev is so, Swamiji was so
strict.
And he told that strict word is that don't meet with Radha Kunda Babaji or Vrindavan or in Navadvip. They think how to test worldly desires. And they, being a male form, they hide their appearance and becomes like ladies and mixing with other ladies and doing all this nonsense. So sometimes we are
misguided
and go and to become a Babaji or like that. But we have seen that so many has done and they have gone to all to hell. So we should not be disguided. We should try to follow our Gurudev. Our Guru Parampara is so bona fide. Swamiji is not first Guru. And he has not established Krishna consciousness first. He is not first Guru. Our first Guru is Krishna. From there, Brahma, Narad, Vyas, Sukadeva Goswami, Madhvacharya, and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, Sarup Damodar, Raya Ramananda, and thus coming Rup Sanatan, Krishna Das Kaviraj Goswami, Narottam Thakur, and thus coming Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur, Baladeva Vidyabhushan Bhakti Vinod Thakur, Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj Bhakti Vinod Thakur, and then Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati, and then he has come. So don't think him. Don't cut his relation to our Guru Parampara. He has nothing given new. Oh, bottle is now, surely. But the
new wine.
Wine is same.
The teachings are same. Same thing. And they never become old. Never. New. Always new. So we should have a belief in this. First there was Vaishnava Raj Sabha. In the time of
Jiva Goswami.
Before that, Madhavendra Puri. Before that, Sukadeva Goswami himself. Before that, Vyasdev. Before that, Narad. Before that, Brahma. So this is coming from there. So we should not try to cut the links of all these things. So this mercy is coming from where? This Bhagavatam is coming from where? From there, from Krishna originally, and Radha and Krishna, or same Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So we have firm belief, very strong belief in our parampara and in these teachings, that in this world, if anyone wants to be happy forever, they should follow this. Very easy. If you are not doing anything, not chanting, you saw any vigraha, Sri Radha Krishna Mahaprabhu, and you did that. Only pranam you will do. Only saying that I am yours, Krishna. Only hearing katha. There is nothing, no matter if you have no money. Nothing. So, you can do this very easily. If you are Muslims, then you are bound to sit and stand and to. And then you'll, what? Mane tumhare saans lete ghabra jayega.
You'll be so tired.
By toil, by doing, and
by this exercise one will start gasping.
So, and we can do. Only if you will not do, no harm. Krishna, aapke liye pranam hai. Only this will do. Have a relation with Krishna. And then automatically we will begin to chant more and more and more, like Haridas Thakur. So don't fear. So Prahlad Maharaj is telling, hearing this, his father becomes so angry, and he ordered all army, senapati,
commander-in-chief.
And just now you should kill this boy. We are so high family, and in our high family, this wicked boy has come. He is not drinking. He is not taking cigarettes. Why this is very strange thing? We try that he should take wine, but he never takes. We have bonded him to take flesh, eggs, but he is never taking. He does not know sham, dam, dand, bhed. What? Sham, dam?
Politics,
politics, duplicity, telling lie,
hypocrisy,
a king or a son of king be like that, telling always lie. He should not speak true. And he should be duplicate.
Duplicious.
And like all this. But this boy is so wicked, not doing anything. So why he came in my dynasty? So you should kill him. Tried hard. Snakes were given to him. Poison was given to him.
Mad elephant
wanted to crush, but when he smelled even coming nearer, and he began to
Competing
and flying. He ran away. He was given to sea, very deep ocean, but Krishna said, he was thrown from
cliff.
Mountains,
but Krishna said, his sister was used. He has a benediction not to be burnt in fire, but she burnt and Prahlad was
saved.
Then he became so upset. And he wanted to kill, but he could not. And then, one day his teacher went to any job, and he told Prahlad Maharaj that, oh, you should
be monitor.
Be monitor and try to control all the boys. Boys were very happy that our Gurudev is going outside, so they were in a mood to play. But Prahlad Maharaj told that, oh, come on, I will tell something to you. You remember? You? Tell. Very strong.
So, the school friends of Prahlad, they were out playing, and they called Prahlad. They said, oh, Prahlad, come and play. But Prahlad, he was not interested in playing. And he said, actually, I have something to tell you. I want to speak from my heart. So very sweetly, he asked, if you could just give me a few minutes, I'd like to explain something. And they said, oh, Prahlad, what it is? What is it that you want to say? So then Prahlad, he explained, Komaram Matret Pragyo, Dhammam Bhagvataiha, Dulabam Manisam Janmam, Tadapi Adruvamatadam. That now we're very young, we're all about 5 years old, but one who's actually intelligent, Komaram Atret Pragyo, that right from the very youth, that Dhammam Bhagavatamiha, that they will engage in Bhagavad Dhamma, in worshipping the Supreme Lord. Why? Because Dulabham Manusam Janma, that this human birth, it's very, very rare. Tadapi Adruva Matadam, that it is rare and it is very temporary. So then his friends, they said, oh Prahlad, this sounds good, but when we get older, then we can worship God. But right now, while we're young, we have our youth, let's go out and play. So then Prahlad, he explained to them, he said, you have this mentality now, but one who's intelligent, they'll understand that if you want to do something, if you plan to do something in the future, then better you do it today. And if you're thinking to do something today, then better you do it now, especially when it comes to taking to Bhagavad Dhamma. So if one is feeling inspired somehow to take to Krishna consciousness, then rather than putting it off for tomorrow or later on, he's saying, no, do it now. So they were saying, no, Prahlad, when we're older, we'll do. Then Prahlad, he explained to them. He said that in life, one may live for 100 years. But even if one lives for 100 years, then 12 hours of the day, one spends that sleeping. So then 50 years, that's lost immediately. You have another 50 years left. And then in the other 50, when one is from age 18 to 100, then in those 20 years, especially if one is engaged in sense gratification, we know when, for instance, if some of us, we may have gone selling paintings in old folks' homes, and these old people from 80 to 100, they don't even reach 100, from 60 to 80, then they're senile. From sense gratification, they've lost everything. So Prahlad is saying from 80 to 100, then one is more or less senile, and one will not be able to, one will not have any capacity to take in any spiritual knowledge. So another 20 years is lost, leaving 30 years. And then in the youth, one is going to school, one loses another 20 years or so going to school, and that leaves 10 years. And in very small childhood, from birth to 10 years of age, then one is practically doing nothing. So he's saying that you may plan that in the future I'll take to Bhagavad Dhamma, but he's saying that this is just a trick of the material energy. That one who thinks like that is a fool, is a mudha. So he said better one should immediately take to Bhagavad Dhamma. So then the boys and girls, they were asking, they asked Prahlad, but we don't know how to take to Bhagavad Dhamma, what to do, how to chant. And then Prahlad, he said, yes, I can teach you. And then he started kirtan.
They asked also, all the boys, that if in our youth we will not collect money and the things for to maintaining our life, then in old age we will have to suffer so much. So what should we do? Yo. Now the Prabhu. What he replied?
He said that.
What here, good?
He said that we see that in life, even though nobody wants distress, nobody wants disease, nobody wants calamity, no one endeavors for these things, yet they are coming automatically as a result of our past activities. So similarly, happiness in this world and facility for enjoyment, it will also come automatically as a result of our past activities.
How they will come? And why they will come?
Due to the reaction of our past activities.
Good and bad activities. If you have done so many bad things, then the result of that will come in suffering. One must die. One must be old. So many rogues and so many things, so many that someday you can be very poor, begging here and there, and someday you can be a king. So if you have done good, then the result of the good activities will surely will come and you will be bound to taste them. If sufferings are coming without invitation, so all good things may come. So don't be afraid of maintaining your life. Prahlad, from where you learnt all these things? You are always with us in school and here playing there. From birth we know you. From where you learnt all these things? Where is Prem Prayojan?
Over there.
Hiding.
Oh, that should be
there. There's a book table, so.
Then, do you remember? What he told?
He explained his
You don't remember perhaps. So, go on.
Yes.
You are not so old like sitting on the chairs. This would be very bold.
Prahlad Maharaj explained that when he was born in the womb of his mother, that because he was the son of Hiranyakashipu, and Hiranyakashipu was very much terrorizing the demigods.
In very
brief.
So he explained that he was kidnapped by the demigods, and then Narada Muni came and he explained because they wanted to kill the child in the womb.
But why?
Indra.
Why?
Indra wanted to, because he was the son of Hiranyakashipu, and they
and
thought
he
would grow to be a very great
more demon. Dangerous than Hiranyakashipu.
Yes.
So in Vaihud, we can kill.
So then Narada Muni came, and he explained to them, no, actually there is a very great devotee in this womb, so you should not kill him.
And you cannot kill.
You cannot kill. So he took him to his own ashram. He took the mother to his own ashram, and there, for many thousands of years, 60,000 years, he kept the mother there, and he was narrating Srimad Bhagavatam.
All the Veda, Upanishad, Shastra, all these scriptures, Vedanta, Upanishad, also Srimad Bhagavat, Mahabharata, Ramayana, everything. And he became expert, being in the womb. But his mother, forget all these things. So, you should be, you follow me, and now we'll give up all the bad activities. You should not think that we are the sons of demons. You should try to give up wine, lust, killing animals, and all these things, bad things. And we should try to do kirtan, assembling here. Now they began to do kirtan. Namami Nandanandanam,
Namami Nandanandanam, Namami Nandanandanam, Namami Nandanandanam,
Namami Nandanandanam,
Namami Nandanandanam, Namami Nandanandanam, Namami
Nandanandanam. Namami Nandanandanam. that day.
With who?
With who? Oh my dear boys and friends, we should always do kirtan, and very powerful kirtan is this. Hare Krishna,
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare, Hare Hare.
What are you doing? What are you doing? You know me? I'm running against the ball!
At once, Hiranyakashipu came. This wicked boy is making all the boys destroy him. Now I am going to kill you. At once, I will see that who is going to save you. Who will save you? That Prahlad Maharaj very
politely
he told. Who is the strongest in you? He is saving the whole world. He is everywhere. In all atoms. Oh, I am not seeing. Oh, you are so much qualified to see everywhere. Then he should come out of this pillar. I am breaking this pillar. And telling this. He, by his
fist.
Did like so, and it was broken, and very big sound.
Tremendous sound came.
Tremendous sound. And he saw that not man, not
lion. Animal.
Animal like this, very ferocious, very powerful. At once he too picked up. Like Garud. Garud means?
Garuda.
Picks up any very weak snake. Like any elephant, mad elephant picks up a
lotus
flower and he wanted to smash Hiranyakashipu. He picked up Hiranyakashipu in his lap. At that time, no night, no day, no upside, not lower, not in the house, not out of house. Not any month,
not any year,
leap year that was, in the evening, and he not
weapon,
he's here, not weapon, and
not in
the
fire.
On the door, And he sat there and picked up in his
lap
and at once and took his all nadi ghuri
intestine
and become reddish and very fearful. Fire began to come from his hair, here and there. All demigods and all began to run quickly here. Brahma and Shankar and Devi,
Lakshmi
Devi also were fear. But Prahlad Maharaj had no fear. All requested Prahlad Maharaj. At once he should go and pacify him. Otherwise he'll destroy the whole world. He at once was playing like boys and very sweetly, and he came and
jumped
in his
lap.
And in spite of being so
angry,
he began to weep. Nishinkadev, I have made so much delay. You will have to suffer so much. Your father has given so much problem for you. So I want that I should give any benediction. He told that I am not a son of businessman, that taking and giving always.
Merchant.
I have not served you for this thing. Then he told again, that, oh mother, my father should be liberated. Oh, Krishna told Nrisimhadev, oh, he has been already done. Those who are very, like Kanishta Vaishnava, following very strictly the principles and chanting something, Hare Krishna, they will be liberated to seven
generations.
Any related father, mother. And those who are Madhyam Adhikari, their father, mother for?
14.
And those who are Uttam, their father, mothers?
21.
21 generation, they will be quickly liberated. So Prahlad Maharaj told that I want to take all the offenses, all the
sufferings
that they have done. All the
living entity,
I will take all their things and they should be liberated and I will be in this world always suffering. Then he told that you will have not to suffer. Those who will chant, remember Krishna and hearing the pastimes of this, they will be liberated. So you should have a strong faith in this. Now, you should come in 10th. Nibirta tarsai rupagi amanat Bausadat srotri mano bhiramat Kahavuttam sloka gunanubadat Virajyet bina pasognat. Parikshit Maharaj, hearing about seven days, 5 days, he has already. He has never wanted, he was never wanting a glass of water, no sleep, nothing, always hearing and hearing.
24 ghante chalte
rahe. All were like this. Yeah, band karo, Vijay. Band karo humko. Jab kahenge. Always hearing. Sukhdev Goswami told, do you want to take water? I don't require. Sukhdev Goswami. If you want water, anything, food, fruits, anything, milk? No, I don't want. I am drinking your nectar of Harikatha. I don't have time. I don't want to waste a minute time. Especially nibritta tarasai upagiyamana, if any realized soul is there, he detached from worldly all kinds of desires and visha means
enjoyments,
and totally absorbed in Hari Krishna, always chanting, remembering, and he has some realization, and he can remove all kinds of doubts. He is like a very good vaidya, medical
doctor.
His medicine is abhyartha.
Without fail.
Infallible. Never be become
never
infallible.
Never infallible. Yeah. So, we should hear katha from him. This is the medicine for worldly persons. Being always happiness. Those who are not hearing all these sweet pastimes of Krishna, they will lose so much. They are like a hunter, hunting himself, killing himself and others also. Those who are taking the flesh and the axe anyhow. If they are not killing, but taking from the market, they are also killer. Those who are making sheds and all these things for that, killing animals and doing all nonsense, they are also hunter. Those who are not hearing, they are more hunter. They are killing themselves and others also. So anyone who wants to enjoy this world, those who are vishayis, those who are nivritta tarshayi, they have no desire to taste this world. Those who are bhakta, all should hear Srimad Bhagavatam. This is a
medicine.
Diet and medicine both.
That means abhyartha.
Infallible.
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 Yes. So, we should hear. Then he told, I want to know now. You have told so many things. So, I want to ask you, Baldev was Sankarsan, and he came in the womb of Rohini, his son. How he became the son of Devaki? How he became? He outwardly he never came in the womb of Devaki, but he is told that hum jo karen theek. He never came in the womb of Devaki. So how outwardly we know that he is the Rohini's Nandan, but why we call? And why Krishna giving of his father and father home at Mathura? He went to Braja. And what activities he done, what pastimes he did there? And again, why he came to Mathura? And Mathura, how many years he was there? And what he did there? And after that, why he went to Dwarka? And he married so many
queens.
How many wives he married there? And how he was doing there? And anything else he had played and done pastimes, I request you to explain here. Then Sukadeva Goswami here became so happy. And he told to Parikshit Maharaj that Vasudeva katha prasna pursan strin punatihi bhaktaram prikchakam shrotram tatpad salam yatha. These pastimes of Krishna are so strong medicine for this world that they pure three things. Those who asking question for hearing Harikatha pastimes of Krishna, that you are asking. And Bhaktaram, who is answering, who is telling, speaking the pastimes of Krishna. And thirdly, who is
listening.
Listening, all. So it makes pure to three, like Ganges water coming from the feet of Bamandev by Bhagirathi for his brothers or
ancestors.
No. Who are killed?
Ancestors.
So he was brought by Bhagirathi. The Bhagirathi was pure. And Shankar was purified. He took Ganges on his head. And then it quickly went to Sagar, to ocean, and where all 60,000 of his ancestors were killed there. And it was touched to current water of Ganges there.
at once they went to Vaikunth. So this katha is like pastimes like that. If anyone is so weak, he cannot give up their bad habits. They want to test world. But anyhow, they will hear all these pastimes very strongly. Then they will be purified certainly. And a Krishna prema will come very quickly in their hearts. Because he has promised in first canto, those who will hear the pastimes of Krishna made by or manifested by Vyasadeva, at once, if anyone have so much honor to hear, at once quickly Krishna will come and be controlled in their hearts. Then Parikshit Maharaj, hearing this, Sukadeva Goswami became so happy and began to answer them. He told that, I want to begin from here, that why Krishna descended to this world and Baladeva Prabhu? This question he answered. Why Krishna came? Paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya to duskritam dharma sansthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge. Krishna has promised to whom? To Arjuna. To son, lakhs and lakhs years before, he has promised that in all yugas, every yuga, in Brahma days, there are so many manvantars, 14 manvantars. And in one manvantar, there are 71 yugas. So all in manvantar one time, and in all yugas, in ekhattar, 71 times I comes to this world, in Brahma one day, to establish yuga dharma, to protect sadhus, devotees, and to
kill
demons, control demons, and to by doing this,
establish
dharma. What dharma? Varnashram dharma. What dharma? Moreover,
Sanatana dharma.
Sanatana dharma. What is Sanatana dharma?
Atma dharma.
That I am not this body. I am soul, part and parcel of Supreme Godhead. I am eternal servant. All are eternal servant of Krishna. Now we have forgot this thing. So in Gita he has told, Vansasi jirnani jatha vihaya namani grihananti naropara tatha sarirani jinyani vihaya nani sanjami namin nainang chidanti nainang
sastrani nainang
dahati pavaka
nainang
nasosiyati maruta. Like this. That we are part and parcels of Himself, Godhead. And we are eternal servant. Not only human body. Not only one of India. Whole world. Not one world. Lakhs and lakhs. We cannot count. Everywhere. Creepers, trees, animals, ants, insects. All are part and parcels of Godhead. We have forgotten anyhow. So for this to establish this truth, transcendental truth, what has been told in Gita? What had been told in Srimad Bhagavatam 11th and 12th canto? Uddhava Sandesh in Vedas, Upanishadas, in Gita, Gita Upanishad. So establish this yuga dharma, especially in Brahma one days, and in one yuga there are four yugas: Satya, Treta, Dwapar, and Kali. In all yugas there are a special yuga dharma. In Satya yuga, meditating, not taking anything. Anyone sitting like this, like Valmiki?
60,000 years.
More than that, 80,000 years sitting like this. Not taking water, air. Dhruv, only 6 months, in 6 months, only 4 months not took water and air. And he, Valmiki, for more than 80 years never took air, no water, nothing. And his body became like soil. Insects took ate all his body. Also, his hoddy.
Bones.
Bone was there, very little, all has gone. And that life was in that very...
Inside the bone.
In the bone. And after that, Brahma came and sprinkled water and he became young. So at that time, human used to be of lakhs and lakhs years their age. At that time, water was pure, air was pure, mind was so pure, they can come in trance. But in Treta Yuga, they used to do yajna, fire sacrifices. In Dwapar Yuga, they could not do all these things. Then,
worship.
Then, worshipping God by tantra. Tantra means by archan, by doing this, making so much big temples. At that time, Jagannath temple was done. Tremendous temple was done. In Badrika Ashram was done. Like this. And deities were worshipped. In Kali Yuga, some Muslim came. So many will come and they will destroy all these things. So Kali Yuga, what dharma? Only Hari Nam Sankirtan. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.
Hare Hare.
So Krishna came to protect from Kansa, Jarasandha, Dantabakra, Durjodhan. They were all demons. And they were forgetting, and they were always drinking, doing all nonsense that world now is going to do, and they are doing. And they think that, we are very intelligent. These are these mind. We will control whole. But they were smashed by Krishna. And what? This religion of Atma Dharma. Atma Dharma, Varnashram Dharma was established. But Krishna never come only for this. Yuga Dharma can come and establish these things. Then why Krishna came? To Dharma Sansthapan. What that Dharma was? Not Varnashram Dharma, not Yuga Dharma, not Manvanta Dharma, not Atma Dharma. Because so many has established before that. Ramchandra had established all these things. But why Krishna came? Then what he has told to Narada Rishi, and Narada Rishi had told to Vyasadeva. What? Janama Dasya Jataha. In first canto, first sloka. Janama Dasya Jataha. Janama Adi Rasa. From where? Adi Ras means Shingar Ras, Braja Ras came. To establish this very thing. This is only the job of Krishna. Nothing else. Other deed? Who killed Kansa? Mahavishnu. Who killed, who fought the Mahabharata Yuddha? Mahavishnu. It was his duty. Krishna never leaves Vrindavan. Always making their devotees happy. Dwarkadhish Krishna and Mathuresh Krishna can be worshipped by devotees. But Brajesh Krishna only serving his devotees, not by served. Always playing with Brajavasi males and females. Sometimes bringing the shoes of his father. Sometimes doing this and that. Stealing? Stealing.
Butter.
Butter. sometimes weeping like this, "Mother, don't beat me. I am
innocent,
and I am taking oath that I will never do like this." You know the relations of Krishna and gopis, no? We think that Krishna is also more superior than gopis. Oh, it is right. But who Krishna called gopis to dance, or gopis came automatically and they danced with Krishna?
Krishna
understand
called.
What my question?
Yes, Krishna called.
Krishna was unhappy. He was lacking something. Gopis never lacking anything. So they were very happy in their houses everywhere, chanting, remembering. But Krishna was feeling some lackness in him. He is ocean of Ras, but ocean was there, Ras was dried. So he wanted to take bath in ocean of Ras, and that is why on full moon he played on flute, "Oh Radhe, Oh Lalite Vishakhe, you should come and save me." That is all gopis. Okay. In Ras, it seems from outside that gopis are searching Krishna. Where is Krishna? Where? And they became mad. But the deep, if you will go, you will see that not that thing. What that thing? That Krishna is feeling so much separation, and he is sitting in Imlitala in Vrindavan. And he became
gold.
From black, yellow he became. Oh, thinking what? Where is Radha? Where is Radha? Where is Radha? So always Krishna searching, decorating, following the footsteps of gopis. Sometimes giving his arms on the neck of gopis. "Oh, save me. Why save me?" Krishna wants love and affection. He does not want to hear the Ved and Stava and Stuti of Brahma and all others. He wants to hear that any gopi is chastising him. Very good. And again he will come. Gopis are chastising that, "Why you have come to still or makkhan?" So Krishna is always serving gopis all. To vinodaya ki
madbhakta vinodaya madbhakta
vinodaya
karomi
vividha kriya. Krishna comes, descends, the supreme personality of Godhead. Only the reason is that he wants to satisfy, he wants to serve, he wants to make happy all his devotees of Brajavasi. So this was the main reason. And then after this, he began Srimad Bhagavatam. We will begin tomorrow. Gaur Prema Maya. Kirtan.
Sri Krishna
Chaitanya.
Oh, drama?
Yes.
So quickly. You should begin and they should make a place for our drama. You should make a place. You can come. And you should also come. First they should go.